इंग्लिश पोयम 14 माई बुक्स. स्टूडेंट्स लेट अस रीड दिस पोयम फर्स्ट. आई लव माई बुक्स. दे आर द होम्स ऑफ क्यून्स एंड फेरीज एंड नाइट्स एंड नोम्स. ईच टाइम आई रीड आई मेक ए कॉल ऑन सम क्वेंट पर्सन लार्ज और स्मॉल हु वेलकम्स मी विथ ए हार्टी हैंड एंड लीड्स मी थ्रू हिज वंडरलैंड. ईच बुक इज लाइक ए सिटी स्ट्रीट along whose winding way I meet new friends and old who laugh and sing and take me off adventuring. Poet is anonymous. It means no author's name is mentioned. So, students, what is this poetry about? This poetry is about books. Do you love books? As someone said, books are man's best friend. This poetry is about reading books. Some people make books as their friends. They love reading different types of books, whether it is novel, stories, adventurous, detective, motivational, autobiography, anything, but they love books. As I told you before, yet I will say it again, there is a famous proverb on books, and that is, books are man's best friend. So, as I said, this poem is about book. Here, the poet is unknown, so it is written as anonymous. It is unknown. So, let us begin the first stanza. I love my books. They are the homes of queens and fairies and knights and gnomes. Explanation. The unknown poet says, I love my books. May she has different types of reading books. She is fond of books. So, she says they are the homes of queens and fairies. It means she likes reading bedtime stories or fairy tales. That's why she has told they are the homes of queens and fairies. It means whenever she is reading the stories of queens and fairies, she takes a round around the palace. Yes or no? So, she says, I love my books. They are the homes of queens and fairies. Now, and knights and gnomes. What is the meaning of knight? K is silent, so we will pronounce it as knights. Knight means soldier or warrior who works for the kingdom. Next one, gnomes. G is silent, so we will pronounce it as gnomes or gnome. So, meaning of gnome is a small, ugly looking person. So, she says she loves her books. They are the homes of queens and fairies and knights and gnomes. So, she likes reading stories of queens, fairy, bedtime stories or fairy tales or the stories of Akbar and Birbal. I will show you some examples. Let us see the pictures of other books. Students, have you read the story of Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs? Have you read? It is a fairy tale story and it is very famous among the kids. See, this is a dwarf or you can say gnomes, a ugly small person. Okay. Next, students, have you read the story of Cinderella and her stepmother and stepsisters? Yes, it is a famous story. Next one, the stories of Akbar and Birbal. It is much famous among kids. The wise minister. Yes or no? Next is Alice in Wonderland. In 90s, when we were kids, Alice in Wonderland used to be aired on Doordarshan. Now, there is a movie on Alice in Wonderland in English. It is shown on English movie channels. If you get a chance, please watch it. So, these were the examples of stories. Different types of stories. Let us read the first stanza. I love my books. They are the homes of queens and fairies and knights and gnomes. Students, I hope first stanza is clear to you. Let us read the next stanza. Each time I read, I make a call on some quaint person, large or small, who welcomes me with a hearty hand and leads me through his wonderland. Explanation. In this stanza, the poetess, the unknown poetess says, Whenever she is reading a story book, she calls a character from the story and she tells them, "Please take me to the world of your story. I want to be the part of the story." And then somebody comes from there, somebody old or a big or small person, meaning of quaint, old man or old person, you can say. So somebody from that story world comes and takes her to their wonderland, just like Alice in Wonderland. Whenever Alice read a story, what happens? She enters the story's wonderland. Just like that, the poetess, unknown poetess, is very much fond of reading. And whenever she is reading, she calls the character from the story and tells them to take her along with them to their wonderland. And she then enjoys the story. Let us read this stanza again. Each time I read, I make a call on some quaint person, old man or old person, big or small, large or small, who welcomes me with a hearty hand. Even they are interested to take this unknown poetess to their world. Who welcomes me with a hearty hand. It means happily they are ready to welcome the unknown poetess. Each time I read, I make a call on some quaint person, large or small, who welcomes me with a hearty hand and leads me through his wonderland. Students, I hope this stanza is clear to you. Let us read the next stanza. Each book is like a city street, along whose winding way I meet new friends and old, who laugh and sing and take me off adventuring. Explanation. She says, whenever she is reading the storybook, she feels she is somewhere at a new place. There she meets new friends. Some are old, some are new, who laugh, sing and enjoy together. And they take her along on their adventure. Yes or no? So, I hope the stanza is clear to you. Let us read the stanza again. Each book is like a city street, along whose winding way I meet new friends and old, who laugh and sing and take me off adventuring. Means every time whenever she is reading the book, she becomes the part of that story. They welcome her with a hearty hand. They are happy to welcome her. They are happy to bring her to their wonderland. And she enjoys all the adventures happening in the story. So this poetry tells us that she loves book, she is fond of reading, she reads different types of books and she enjoys reading. So students, let us read the whole poetry once again. Poetry 14, My Books. I love my books. They are the homes of queens and fairies and knights and gnomes. Each time I read, I make a call on some quaint person, large or small, who welcomes me with a hearty hand and leads me through his wonderland. Each book is like a city street, along whose winding way I meet new friends and old, who laugh and sing and take me off adventuring. So students, I hope this poem is very well clear to you. Thank you.